Welcome to part 17 of Dynasty Warriors 9, and in this episode, we're going to continue where we last left off. And that is to finish up Changban and also finish up Chapter 5. Which means we're going to have to get our way through Wei first. And in order to complete this mission, we have to defeat Shunyo, Zhanghe, and Xiaohu Yuan, who are waiting at dockside. Unfortunately, these guys may be high maintenance, but the peasant, on the other hand, is not really that strong. So bear that in mind.
The enemy's response has exceeded my expectations.
And the peasant's going to try to run into Xiaohu Yuan like an idiot. Of course he is. But to be fair, if I could actually defeat Xiaohu Yuan before the peasant comes by, this would make things easier on me. All he has to do is go to his homeland and he's good.
What a show, brother!
I ended up getting a scroll, and now that takes care of Xiaohu Yuan. Who, by the way, also serves a weapon with Taishin Sir. And with that said, we've got rid of Xiaohu Yuan's forces.
Due to your efforts.
This also means
we've reached the pier safely.
That the peasant can actually hop off of the boat and go straight to his village. And check and see what's wrong. In fact, that's what I'm going to do. In order for us to make sure the peasants are safe, we're going to have to conquer the village.
The village is under bandit control. We'll have to defeat
because the village has been taken over by freaking bandits. Of course, it's always got to be them bandits. Why must it always be bandits? But the peasant will be fine. All we have to do is take care of the bandits first. And that'll take care of two. I said that it would take care of two birds with one stone. Last part, this part, I really mean it.
These idiot villagers belong to us.
And I also forgot that I ran out of spirit potions. I gotta go make some more.
You said it.
Nonetheless, the only way for this to end is if we take out the. Actually, no, we gotta take out everyone here. Not just the bandit leader. We gotta take out every single bandit that's here. Once we do, then, and only then, will the peasants be able to return home and be able to escape. I do know for a fact that we'll be closing in on doing a mission where we will have to try to rescue Liu Shan. I mean, that says a lot, but still, this is a pretty long battle and I am getting shook by bandits. This is embarrassing. I am being shook by bandits. God damn it. This is degrading. I cannot be defeated by bandits. I'm sorry, I can't be defeated by bandits. That would be the most embarrassing thing in the world. But whatever the case, that takes care of the bandits.
You defeated those evildoers.
There aren't any. There aren't much left, actually, to be honest. So on that note, the village is safe, and that also means the villager has been saved.
This victory was made possible due to your efforts.
So, now that we've got- Oh, we got that one done too.
That was most impressive.
So with all the villagers rescued, and they can go back to their village, that just makes things easier. And notice, I just went there and skipped ahead two missions in one go. For the most part, at least I managed to make it easier on myself so the villagers won't be shafted by the bandits. And my controller came apart. Ah, god damn it! Hold on a minute. Give me a second, I'll get it back to normal. There we go. Now then, on to the next mission. And let's see. This mission is going to be us going after Cao Cao. Yeah, I know, it sounds a little bit insane, but this will be the only time that we'll be facing Cao Cao. Because, see, here's the problem. This isn't the only time we got Mao Ding Zhen, but this is the only time in this chapter where we'll actually face Cao Cao himself. So we're facing his foot soldiers for quite some time. And now all that's left is Cao Cao. So, all I have to do is just find him and get rid of this dock.
Leaving this place undefended is dangerous.
Wait, actually, I meant to say Cao Cao's forces in general. Normally, this would be like a compiled group of soldiers, but there are officers here.
Time to take the attack.
In fact, there was one of them just now. And now for another one.
Capturing that area will deflate their morale.
Let's see. Camera should be moving right in my direction. Just give me a few seconds here.
I must fall back.
There, done. Xiao Ho Shang has been defeated. And all that's left is Cao Chu. I thought I was fighting Cao Cao. Wait, no. I do fight Cao Cao in this battle. It's just the fact that he's probably the next mission.
I am most grateful for your aid. This will allow
but nonetheless, we've got this one done, so that way all the reinforcements will be coming to Liu Bei's aid, and there won't be anyone cutting
this
them off.
This victory was made possible due to your efforts.
I'm pretty sure that there's going to be another mission added on. In fact, let me, before I do that, fix up all of my stats that I gain. I can't just be going around like some weakling, you know? And I gotta make sure that everything is, like, up to speed and also caught up. So with that said, instead of going to the main building, let's go after Cao Shu and then we'll rescue the Handmaiden. No big deal. He's the opposite way. All I have to do is just hop on a horse and ride to him. That's all I gotta do. No, I'm not bored. I'm just trying to get my bearings together. Alright, now it's time for Cao Shu. Cao Shu, we're gonna beat him up and we're gonna make sure that our enemies are out of our way so we will have an easier time to cross the bridge. And also, we gotta kill off the stragglers too. They gotta go as well. More experience, the better.
I am forced to retreat.
And with Cao Shu forced
to
retreat,
my lord, when he needed me the most,
I think that means that we've all but won this war. No, we're not won this war. I mean, more like all but won this battle. Yeah, we're still gonna have to retreat to Xiaku, but at least we don't have to worry about Cao Cao too much, because now Cao Shu has pretty much backed off. Why am I going to the main fight? Why am I doing that? I don't need to. And of course I caught wind of a base. But excuse me one second, I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Now that we went there and cleared out a good portion of all these missions, now we're gonna start doing the Rescue the Handmaiden mission, which is gonna open up two different missions, both of which has a lot to do with rescuing Liu Shan. So with that said, we gotta first save the Handmaiden from the bandits.
Someone!
Or these Cao Cao soldiers.
Someone!
Which, by the way, ever since Cao Cao showed up, for some reason, bandits have tripled. Whatever the case, the Handmaiden must not be defeated.
This is Providence
but
itself.
But seeing as how you'll be able to get there before the Handmaiden dies, that just makes things easier for you. Oh, and also, this is an escort mission. Because we can't just have enough escort missions in this game, now can we?
Show the enemy no mercy!
Whatever the case, we're just going to murder all of the guys that stand in our way. And we almost did. There's one guy here and one more guy behind me.
All right.
That is Changba, basically.
I can't bear this any longer.
But it's okay.
Those who stand in the way of virtue shall fail.
All we need to do is just take care of one more group of troops, and that should take care of.
My thanks so much for all your help.
She's actually being hounded.
About Lord Liu Chan, I can't possibly save him myself.
Oh wait, no, she actually made it. Okay, that was it. We just had to defeat Changba. But whatever the case.
This victory was made possible.
Now we need to take whatever information that we got, because I think we got a new one. Rescue Mizu. And we still got this one to do. Let's make sure that's all the that's all of them we have to do. Because the last time we ended up finding a new mission and I accidentally didn't do it. Oops. But nonetheless, rescuing peasants definitely came in handy, because we actually have ships for them to escape in.
Where are you taking me?
Now then,
there is
we're gonna have to take
concern.
Down Shun Yu this time.
Taking you to my lord.
Which is weird, because he has not been in any of the playthroughs thus in the playthrough thus far, but this is the first time he's here, and I think he's gone by the end of Chirby. If not Chapter 7.
I see your every move.
But nonetheless, be careful of Shun Yu. Actually, no, he has daggers, never mind. Just be prepared to block. If this was 8, I would say be careful of Shun Yu and his strategist rod, because his strategist rod will trap you and cause some great deal of damage. Yeah, the strategist rod was broken back in Dynasty Warriors 8 Empires. And now, he shares the same weapon with Yuanji and Xu Rong. The clone weapons.
Army is capable of more than just running.
It really was a dick move for Koei to went there and resell all of the best weapons that came from some of the officers everybody loved as DLC. It really was a dick move. But on the bright side, we still have weapons that they actually gave us, like the Jubilation Spear and the Party Launcher, I believe. And I captured an important base, however that important base was for to defeat Shun Yu.
This victory was made possible due to your efforts.
But now that Mizu is safe, Mizu may actually know where Liu Shan is. So, the only thing that is left is... Oh god, there's another one. Defeat Shahu In. We gotta defeat him and continue on. Ironically enough, Shahu In is not too far. And by defeating him, this will actually give us some more morale to work with.
Is flee. Crush them.
Let's see, he should be around here somewhere. Ah, there he is, and he's rallied.
I'm a soldier.
Great.
Of Liu Bei.
Let's chop him to bits. I'll probably be done fleeing Changban by the morning time, at least. It's nighttime now.
For my heroes, even
I just realized it literally
myself.
Went from nightfall running from Cao Cao all the way till... It was daytime we were running from Cao Cao, and now it's nightfall in the second part of doing so, we're running from Cao Cao.
I thought I was dead.
It's kind of a shame that all we've been doing is running from Cao Cao.
I've heard something about Lord Liu Chan.
But that is the life of Liu Bei, of course.
Those who stand in the way of virtue shall fail.
And we got some ginseng, I got some...
This victory was made possible due to your efforts.
Kronos Berry, or whatever the hell that was. Chossel Barrel, that's what it was. And we got two more areas. Oh! There's another one! And this is the mission we was looking for! We have to beat Shao In to find his son. And now it's time for Liu Bei to continue to be a good dad by rescuing his own son instead of relying on Zhao Yun. Whatever the case, we're just gonna take care of everybody that stands in my way. He's not too far behind, or at least not too far from where I last teleported. All I have to do is just go into the village and practically meet up with the handmaiden. That's all I need to do. And they'll probably get Liu Shan to safety.
Oh, finally. In fact, aid, please, with me. Lord
since
Liu Shan is
met
aid.
Up with the handmaiden.
We are surrounded by the enemy. Please, take
all
Lord
we have
Liu
to
Chan
do is just take Liu Shan and run.
The one caring for Lord Liu Chan.
Ironically
is
enough,
in the village up
I think
ahead.
If you were doing
please
this as Xiao Yun, you had to take Liu Shan and make it to Liu Bei. But seeing as how all I have to do is just
Liu Bei's forces,
run to the area and just beat everybody that's there, I don't have to worry too much about the enemy. And you just saw that whole entire area got filled with another pickup item that just popped right in. And oh look, the sun's about to rise. We have been trying to stall out Cao Cao all night. Hold on, let's just capture this port right here. Booyah, there, port captured. Not like it's gonna do any good, because it'll be back in Cao Cao's possession at the beginning of the next chapter.
We can win every area we take.
So since we came here, you think that there would be enemies here, right? Nope. Just simply hand the baby over to the handmaiden.
I'm so glad you are safe.
But if I wasn't playing as Liu Bei, this would be handed over to Liu Bei.
I wish you well too.
Nonetheless, this mission is done. I think there's one more mission left. And then I think there was two more actually. And then we could go on ahead and probably end this chapter.
Whoa, what a show.
Oh wait, no. That was a base right there. Just have to make sure that there was nothing else standing in our way. First off, a level 53 base. No, this is where we attack Cao Cao. Yes, we're actually going to take the fight to Cao Cao and make him retreat. And all that we have left are the two base, one or two missions after that, and then we'll be good. We just waltz right into his castle. At least the castle doors didn't close in my face like it did in part 15. Or I think 14 it was. Yes, it was part 14. I was breaking into the castle. If anybody hadn't saw it, it would be ridiculous if you have. But I was breaking into the castle, and all of a sudden the doors just popped in, closed shut, kept me out, and I had to climb over the wall. It was ridiculous, and the doors was literally wide open. So now all we have to do is just take out Cao Cao and all the guys that happen to be. Oh, and they're all, good lord have mercy, they're all rallying. Just the kind of thing I want. That was sarcasm. I don't want that. I don't want that at all. Get off of the house, you fool! And I found that really retarded that my Liu Cao stopped on the dime. Oh crap! We've got three rallying officers. That's not good. Not good at all. Hopefully I can just take down Cao Cao. He's the only one I have to deal with. And from the looks of it, I probably will. If I don't get beaten up by Mizushu.
To assemble many.
Come on, I just need a finisher right quick.
I feel he is a hero worthy of being labeled.
And
my
boom!
Hero.
That takes care of Manchong and now for Zushu. Oh god! Zushu is really putting the hurt on me, man.
This victory was made possible.
But that's okay. All that's left is actually securing the bridge. And we're still fighting Zushu. What'd I say, Zushan? I must be. Oh god, no, Manchong's still alive. Never mind. Oops. Yeah, screw that one up too. Come on now, we can finish this. And then afterwards, we gotta help Zhang Fei scream at the bridge. No, I'm just kidding. He does that. We don't do that. Zhang Fei would actually scream at the bridge and pretty much make sure that the Wei forces would not impede our path. So on that note, it's time to help Zhang Fei. So let's go over to secure the Changban River, and that's it. Or the Changban Bridge. So, this mission, if Zhang Fei falls, that's it, it's over. However, if you're playing as Zhang Fei, you don't have to worry about that. All you have to do is just simply don't die. That's it. And even if you do, I forgot to mention this about the game. Doesn't matter what difficulty it is, you will be able to take an item and actually get back into the fight if you die. So, difficulty really doesn't matter! They'll even actually have it to where you'll be able to make yourself an item provided you have the means to do so. So all we're practically doing is facing Xiao Houdun and Zhang Liao, who is trying to keep Zhang Fei from crossing the bridge. We can't have any of that, and Xiao Houji is with us too. Yeah, we can't have those two keeping us from crossing the bridge.
Happy to see you here, but still.
And that took care of that.
I seem to be having some trouble here. I should fall back before things get
worse. All that's left now
worse.
Is for us to go over to
fires of necessity.
Jiaku, and Jiaku is actually controlled by Cao Pi. He's the main villain, or more along the lines of he's the main boss of the last chapter. Okay, let me rephrase that. He is the boss of this chapter, since we already took down Cao Cao. By taking down Cao Cao, Cao Cao cannot rejoin Cao Pi to make things harder for you. So everything we just did, we held off Cao Cao's forces, we held off everyone else trying to take care of all of our soldiers, we helped Liu Shan, and now we probably should have enough high morale so that we can rush into Jiako and we can defeat Cao Pi. Which, by the way, should not be too hard. Because unlike the fight with Cao Cao, I'm actually overleveled. And by overleveled, I'm level 69. Like the most ironic level to be right now.
Here they come. It looks like
all jokes aside. Now, this is time for us to try to climb over the wall. There's a lot of dead soldiers here. Too bad their bodies disappear. Unlike with the 6 and 7, at least their bodies stay put.
I hope it provides you comfort on the journey to the afterlife.
That's alright. We just need to climb up the wall and not get hurt. Yeah, I saw all those boulders. Let's get rid of you guys. Yeah, because I'm getting sick and tired of being waylaid by a boulder every time I climb up here. And again, did ask for more difficulty. I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. Nonetheless, if I took care of this base, there might be a little less people for us to worry about. Or at least, a little less people throwing bricks at us.
Now is the time to attack.
All right,
but instead, the game would have a frame rate drop right in the middle of me jumping in midair. Yeah, way to go, game. And while we're at it, I do believe we've just found ourselves one of the enemies we deal with. We have to take care of everybody here. And the first person we ran into, if I'm not mistaken, was... that's Cao Ren. Well, that was Cao Ren. Now all that's left is Jia Xu, Zenji, and Cao Pi is the only one here right now. And I screwed up my Musou. Why did I do that? At least I made 3,000 kills. It should be more than that, but still. I don't have time to be dawdling around with kills. Eventually I'll get it. Eventually. If I feel like it. But nonetheless. We just gotta watch out for Zenji. We gotta watch out for Cao Pi. Because they will try to rally. And that's the last thing you need. Is for soldiers to rally. Honestly, I was hoping that Jia Xu would have got caught in the counter trap, but unfortunately, that did not happen. And he's done. Oh god, I got hit in the face with a brick. Oh, come on! Okay, at least you know the game's not as easy as I normally originally said. All I can say is I just got waylaid by boulders. And that's the last thing anybody would want, is to be waylaid in the face with boulders. But at the end of the day, there's the two I need to kill. I need to make sure I get every last officer out of this place so that we can meet Su Xuan in peace. And broker peace. Well, provided he actually listens. But unfortunately, when we get to that road, that's going to be the next episode. But not this episode. No, we're finishing Chapter 5. And that was freaking awesome right there. I just got killed in the backlash. No, I didn't get killed, but rather, I got pushed back in the backlash of my exploding barrel after I put my bow back in its quiver. I don't know what to say about that. But nonetheless, Zenji is defeated and all that's left is Cao Pi. Once we take care of him, that takes care of Jia Xu. And with that said,
I have no choice but
we pretty much got this battle all but won.
There's little point in resisting.
And now,
do so. I must retreat.
At least we can make the soldiers retreat. Unless there's actually someone here. Well, nope. Those are the only ones left.
Cao Cao will not chase us any further.
And with that, Cao Cao and his forces are forced to retreat for now. But they will be back. They'll be back in full force. And that's the last thing.
The road was harsh and unforgiving, but we have finally made it as far as Xiaku. I could never have reached here without all of your help. Thank you.
But once again, we have lost a place to call our home.
This place could come under attack at any time as well. What do we do then? Keep on running away?
If we continue to flee every time we are invaded, that will simply spread the conflict further. Now that we have Zhuge Liang amongst our number, we cannot afford to keep doing that.
You mean it is finally time to stand up to Cao Cao?
I have been looking forward to facing him in battle. But as much as I hate to say it, his forces outnumber ours, you know?
As a way of overcoming that handicap, Zhuge Liang has been considering forming an alliance with Master Sun Quan of Jiandong. I do not know if he will be amenable to our request. But for now, we must hope that this plan will work.
Messenger from Jiandong. Master Sun Quan has agreed to meet with me. I intend to discuss an alliance with Wu at this meeting, as well as measures to counteract Cao Cao.
Very well. Still, are you sure you want to go alone?
Yes. I believe they will be less wary and more amenable to hear what I have to say if I am on my own.
I see. It is a crucial task which awaits you, but I have faith that you will perform it admirably.
Thank you, my lord. For the sake of your grand ambition, I will secure this alliance.
And with that said, ladies and gentlemen, we are done with the pursuit of Changban, and not to mention Chapter 5. As I walk away from Xia Ku without any problems or any delays, I think it's safe to say this chapter is done and we're about to go into Chapter 6, which is actually one of the longer ones in the game. But before that, it's time for end of chapter eliminations. You know the deal, bring the victim! He came, he saw, he told us Zhuge Liang was that way, and he left. Pretty much sums up Xu Xu in a nutshell. The funny part is, he's another officer that has DLC what-if scenarios, but I didn't bot him, so oh well. I'll see you guys in the next episode as we start Chapter 6 and Chirby. This is RVMan.A5. Peace out.